I think we're on. Good evening, good evening. Oh yes, just come up on my phone. St George's Church is live now, so I think I'm on. So yes, good evening. Oh, there goes, yeah. Good evening, hi. Welcome to Friday night's Thoughts for the Night. Yes, I'm Dave. Dave Jenner, one of the church wardens at St George's Church, Freezy Water. Good evening, Ron, Jane, Hannah. Father Taman, spoke to you just now at our church wardens meeting. Carol, Sharon, good evening, Ronnie. Nice to see you. Yes, I just thought I'd say, some of us have seen New Year's, yes. Many of us are now having our COVID vaccine. And yes, it was my turn this week on Wednesday, late afternoon, only a couple of days ago, and I had to go up to the Evergreen Centre at Edmonton Green, near very nice, and I found out I had the Oxford jab, AstraZeneca type, and was advised, could ache a bit for a couple of days, which I must admit I do. Even Jay says I look a bit grey, sort of, yeah, just aching, you know. I call it the old... well, the ladies call it man flu, don't they? Get those sort of symptoms. And yes, a bit stiff. And they did say yes for a couple of days. And I know a couple of people who sort of had a day laid up. So making no excuses tonight. I'll do my best. Very sorry if it's... might be a bit shorter tonight. But got a bit of a theme tonight. I'm 62 and a bit. So, yeah, they're down to... people in their 60s now, so it's all going very well. And I'll just say a couple of more hellos before I carry on. Good evening, Sue, Hannah, yes, Sharon, Roy, Isabel, Jean Webb, Jean Benson. Isabel, are you still over here, or have you gone back to Australia? Let me know. So, but nice to see that you're on. So, yes, Margaret. So, I try and be my usual jokey self, but as I say, feeling a bit stiff, you know, man flu, you know what it's like. So I do apologise now. And I know last Sunday at Mass, Father Taman said, ready for Ash Wednesday, which is on the 17th of this month, Wednesday week, that we, because normally when we are in church, people would return their palm crosses. So we sort of thought of an idea for where we could still, even though we're not meeting in church, to collect the palm crosses. So this week, if I can find a photo, and if you wish to return your palm crosses, you can. I do apologise, you know, I'm getting there. So yes, I don't know how clear it comes out on screen, but... it's probably too bright, but what it is, there's you might be able to see that there's a bucket, and you can see the three crosses, obviously of as depicting sort of Christ and the two thieves he had next to him, and there's a nice silver bucket, and basically that is situated in the port of the church, the vestry entrance. So it's in the port, so it's in the dry, like where recently we had the box for the stakes, for the wreaths at Christmas. So it's in the it's sort of in the same place. So yeah, so from now until, you know, next weekend, you can, if you wish to, return last year's palm crosses that can be used to burn, to have the ashes for Ash Wednesday service in the evening, when Father Taman will put on those who will be able to be there that night, which will probably be his family, maybe myself as church warden, Irene. So on behalf of you. So yes, if you want to, you can now return during the day, just put them in the bucket, and that will be very nice of you. So, yes, as you know, when I sort of do, I suppose I've been a bit regular, I suppose, now on Thoughts for the Night on a Friday, the T4TN. So, and as you know, I normally, well, not normally, I always do, choose a song at the end. Sometimes I've had one sort of in the middle, depending on the theme for the night. And it's sort of normally ones that I've enjoyed over my years, of be it a pop song, rock song, hymn, or something, sometimes classical. So I thought tonight I'd talk a little bit, and you can join in, about sort of my love for music, and sort of share you with a couple of stories behind what I like, and you can obviously comment on what you like and what I might play tonight, and hope you also like the small bit of some of my favourites. Not I can't choose everything, because we'd be here all night, wouldn't we? But today, carefully, I've some of you might know, but the old classic, I used to collect all the vinyl, the 45s and the LPs, 33 and a third, and from when I was, 14, 15, especially my teenage years, where I started to buy a lot. And I've still got them all. Would you believe it? I've still got them all. I've kept them. I still have a record player that's a more modern, and occasionally I get the old vinyl out. No sound quite like it, the old scratchy bit. So I'm just going to go through a few bits tonight, through my catalogue, but not too heavy. So just a couple of hellos before we start on that. Good evening, Debbie. Good evening, Janice. Maureen. Good evening, Diane. Nice to see you all. So I would... we had it recently, wouldn't it? I think I played... unfortunately, when he passed away, wasn't it? Jerry Marsden. I played... Ferry Across the Mersey, because that was my first album. And when I was about sort of 14, 13, I'm going to show you, is it, look at that. I know the words are going to be backwards, but I'm sure you know them. Yeah, Slade. That was sort of my first sort of band that I sort of got really into. Yes, and I've got a few of their albums, Slade, yeah. You probably, Goodbye to Jane. Well, not my Jane. Yeah, Mum are real crazy now. So there I am, showing my age. And I will just play one of my first favourite records. And you'll probably recognise this if you... We're going back to Top of the Pops, 1973. If I can play it. And this is Slade. Anyone know the title? If you do, put it down. Slade always had about spelling things. Remember Noddy Holder? There he is. And this is actually playing on Christmas Day on Top of the Pops, 1973. I don't think Merry Christmas Everybody, I think it was out that year, or 74. But there you go. There's my first one. We'll stop that. Yeah, so it was, Come On and Feel the Noise, but Come C-U-M, and Noise was, had a Z in it and everything. Yeah, lovely. So that is, well done, Father Vince, great band, yes. Yeah, so from, old dancey, Come On and Feel the Noise. So moving on, I always remember when we are going back a few years, but it was an LP, which I will show you, when my daughter Rebecca was about, I don't know, six or seven, she was, she did her dancing, she did a bit of ballet and modern tap music, and she'd come home today, she'd, oh, Dad, for this show, I'll Get Around by the Beach Boys. So she said, oh, if you've got it, and then I can practice at home. And because she was an age, by then, CDs were the in thing, vinyl had sort of gone. So I got my Beach Boys Greatest Hits, and she, I always remember getting out, and she said, that's a big CD, Dad, how's that going to fit in the player book? And I remember I recorded it on the old cassette player, so then she could practice her dancing, but it just shows you. And back in the 70s, do you remember that one? That was a clatch. Do you remember Tubular Bells? And there's a bit of a story, because that was one of the first LPs, very all instrumental, very unusual at the time, And I loved it because the intro, or the main, is from the film The Exorcist, not a bit of a horror movie. Some of you will probably know that. And it was on Virgin Records, and because that was when Richard Branson, we all know now, don't we? The phones, the Virgin Media, Virgin Airlines. And that was, he put the money up and he recorded in Mike Oldfield's garage, and it went on the Virgin label, and as we say, the rest is history. So, so probably that's about 73. So by then I was about 14, 15. And I'll tell you, my first group I ever saw live, you might have, probably most of you heard of them, Cockney Rebel, Steve Harley and Cockney Rebel, come up and see me sometime. And I saw them at the, some of you probably know it, the Rainbow Theatre in Finsbury Park, because you get past Finsbury Station, you go around the one-way system, and in front of you, I think it's a religious church now, but in them days, it was, that was about October 74. I just left school, I was 16. And then in the November, I went to see Queen for the first time. A lot of my friends, some of you are probably aware in the church, the best band I've ever seen live, and I saw them about 12 times. Even with Jane, my wife, on their last ever concert as The Four back in 1986 at Nebworth. And of course, a lot of people, you'll recognise that, the style there, because it's obviously Bohemian Rhapsody. I love LPs because you open them up and you get the white and the black, and it's, yeah, brilliant. What can I say? Queen, whatever more. And I'll just play another couple of quick intro, see if you can get them. And what was that? There used to be that program, wasn't it? Beat the Intro, was it? And they used to play a bit on a piano, and you won prizes, I think. Here we go, I like this one as well. At the time, back in the 80s. I don't want to skip survey. Anyone know this one? Old Jan saw the Beatles. You saw the Beatles at the Finsbury Park? Rainbow, yep. Father Vince, you're on the ball. Yep. How about this one? This is for the ladies. Oh, sorry about, got a video. No, we forget that. Oh yeah, you like this one? Oh, come on. Sorry about this. This is another one of my favourites. I love this band. Then with the days, Top of the Pops on a Thursday night, 7:30. It's be Brian Conley with a lovely blonde hair. Sweet. Oh, Ronnie. Right, this one. Where's The Quo? I saw The Quo at Hammersmith Odeon in 70, about a couple of years, 75, 76. And it was in the days everyone wore their denim. I had a denim jacket, a denim shirt, denim trousers. Yeah, giving it. What was it? The Three Chords, wasn't it? Three Chords, weren't it? And moving on a bit, well, a little bit further on. And, I know it's back in the 70s. Ziggy Stardust, I would recommend it. David Bowie, to anyone. It's one of those albums, this is me, but hasn't got a bad track on it. There's 11 tracks. They're all brilliant. I would suggest it to any bit of a collector's item. But we move on, and do you remember these? I know it's going to be backwards, I will explain. Now that's what I call music. And this is the very first one And here we go. Look, you get the sleeve. Sorry, turn it round to you. I know you can't see them all. And who's on it? I'll tell you this. Phil Collins, Duran Duran, Heaven 17, Culture Club, Kajagoogoo. Oh, you remember this? Great, the old mullet. Paul Young. Yeah, and this is the first ever one. It's about 1983. I mean, what number are they on now? 100 and something? But this, I've got the first 20 on vinyl, but this was, that's why it hasn't got a number, because it was the first ever one. And what they give out, what, 3 or 4 a year? 2 or 3? Maybe not so much now. I mean, now you download them, don't you? But yeah, that was the first ever one. You probably recognise some old faces there. Look, there's Duran Duran in it, and Lamont Culture Club at the top there. Howard Jones. Oh, everyone's a winner. Yeah, and of course, I will, you remember this one. Down the old disco. Brilliant. It's a four fender, isn't it? Doing the old... Oh, yeah. 77, 78, wasn't it? Good film. Who's the star in this film? Who played the main? Who did the in the white suit? Put your comments on. Yeah. Airplane, your clip. Yeah, my collection, it might be worth money, yeah. There you go. Good evening, Claire. Yeah, no, big bucks. Yeah, well, you know. Keep me in retirement. John Travolta. Father Vince, you're excellent. Oh, Lynn, of course. Yeah, brilliant. Yeah, John Travolta. And of course, this is probably more Jane's one. It might be mine. I think it's a Thriller, Michael Jackson, brilliant. Yet again, brilliant tracks. Probably, well, I don't know, is it the top selling LP of all time? Probably is, before he went a bit off. Yeah, Billie Jean, what a record. What we got, Human Nature, and of course, Thriller. I always remember, was it on, help me out. They had a video, didn't they? And it was on that channel. What was it called? MTV, is that it? And I always remember the video for that was like a well-made, John Landis was the director, very similar to, if you ever see American Werewolf in London, because obviously he changes into, yeah. But it's, what a video, with old, was it Vincent Price, with the laughs at the end, and they're doing the dance, aren't they? Yeah, brilliant, I mean, it was, yeah, because they always, everyone knew it was going to happen, and everyone sat down and watched it. It was one of those things that you, oh yeah, it's Wednesday night at 8 o'clock, Michael Jackson's Thriller. You've got to see the video. And I always remember, yeah, seeing that. Yeah. Quick question. Who writes the allotment section in the newsletter? Claire, that is, C. Ray, Christopher Ray. Yes. Thank you. Right, and another one I will show. Going back before that, that's another brilliant one. I always like the Rumours by Fleetwood Mac. Yet again, another album I would say, ain't got a bad track on it. And I always like that one, The Chain, because if you know that, it's the intro when Formula One used to be on the BBC, when it goes, dum, 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 and that's on that album. And of course, I've got to show you, this is my Crusaders, Street Life, my first ever, do you remember when the 12-inch single, early 80s, middle 80s, yeah, and it was the Crusaders, but Street Life, and it was, the singer was Randy Crawford, but that was my first ever 12-inch single. I've got a few, but yeah, just saying, that was my first ever one. And yeah, a few of these bands I'm showing you, I've seen. Saw Light, I saw obviously Queen, and I saw Eric Clapton. I've seen ELO, The Who, Bad Company, Deep Purple. Finlay's E, Status Quo, a bit rocky. And we, in them days, I always remember, we used to friend, some of you will know him, Alan Hiscox. He used to follow a few bands, and we used to go Saturday, Sunday nights to the, it was called the Brett Knock. It's a pub, it's, I don't think it's called that now, just on the Seven Sisters Road as you go past Holloway Prison. It used to be like local bands. Used to be going to another pub in Barnet. Used to see local bands, and yeah, and you go in, yeah, playing live, brilliant. Nothing like it, playing live. And used to, I'll show you now, you've probably never heard of them, but there's a, this is called Midnight Wire by Curved Air. Bit weird. They used to play in like colleges, like in the Students' Union place up in London. Used to go up there regular. And this later one, is the drummer here. That's his picture. And that is Stuart Copeland, who was their last drummer, who, when the band split up, he formed a new band. And Alan said, I don't know if he was in the old fan club of Curved Air. He said, Stuart Copeland's in a new band. And they were playing a pub, it's like the Marquee up in Oxford Street. He said, he's in a new band. He said, I think they're called The Police. Never heard you have known that. And he said, do you want to go on somewhere? And yeah, because they weren't, I call it first on the bill. They didn't come on to about midnight, 12:30 in the morning, you know. And because at that time it was sort of the punk period, which I was not into. I love the Jam, and right, they're not punk, are they? Madness, that's two sort of two-tone type music. Scar, as they call it, the Specials. More, I preferred that. But no, we went to see, and him and obviously Sting, we didn't know at that time, and Andy Summers, the guitarist. They all had orange hair, and I must admit, they weren't very good. And I thought, they're not going to do, he's not going to do anything with them. Because 6 months later, Walking on the Moon's at number one, the rest is history. And we went to, next time we saw him was at Hammersmith Odeon with like 5,000 people. Just shows you, what do we know, you know? So that was another interesting fact. And I'll play another tune, see if we can, if you can guess this. Bear with me. All right, who we got? I always remember this one. Great one. It was his first number one. Do you remember this? Because Elton John at the time never had a number one on his own. But who's he with here? I saw her at the theatre in Tottenham Court Road. On her up when she had a band. Anyone put your... Isabel, well done, Kiki D. Yeah, Curved Air, Backstreet Love. Father Vince, I've got to have a chat with you, mate. Yeah. Backstreet Love, yeah. Yeah, Kiki D. But that was Elton's first so-called number one. He's had number one since then, but yeah. And this is, we are going back even further, but this is one of Jane's favourites. I thought I'd play this. Remember? Jane will be happy. One of her favourites. I know it's going back to the 60s, but why not? And of course, the next one, I will play it now before I move on. I saw this band live at Els Court about 79. Electrolight Orchestra. Big intro to, you'll know this one. Brilliant song from one of those. Classic. I always remember, yeah, saw him at Els Court. I'm sure it was Els Court, 78 or Wembley. It might have been Wembley Arena. And yeah, brilliant. I always remember it's Mr. Blue Sky, the old big thing went up there, great big design. And don't think I got it yet. Oh, read that earlier on, Saturday Night Fever. Yeah. Elton, Goodbye Yellow Brick Road. These albums, look. Three sides, look. And also, this is going back a couple of years before. I know Corinne Dowse, it's not on tonight, but doing the old dance takes me back to the old discos, scout group, dinner dance. 1974. You can't but help dance, tiger feet, mud. And another one, our friends, and probably you, like to dance too. This is it. We're going back into the 80s. Dun, dun, dun. Anyone know this? Yes, Carol's just put it. She said, let's just turn this down a bit so you need water. Come on, Eileen. Yes, Carol says, you must have had a lot of pocket money. Well, yeah, I suppose when I was 14, 15, I got, as you did in them days, I got a paper round. It's a shop. Well, I don't know if it's still there now. It's opposite Albany Swimming Pool, newsagents. And yeah, because most Saturdays, when I sort of at school, left school, there used to be a couple of record shops in Waltham Cross. And we used to go down there, and of course in them days it was like the top 20, and you and your mates would buy the top 20 and you swap them and, you know, play them on your record player at home. I obviously got a bit of pocket money, but then I got a paper round. And just quickly, I used to, in them days, I did the four big tower blocks in Bell Lane, named after islands of Jersey, Guernsey, Herne, Sark. And in them days, this is genuine truth, I used to leave my bike at the bottom and then get the lift up to the top and then walk all the way down delivering the papers, and my bike was still there when I got down there. Yeah, times have unfortunately changed a bit since then. But yeah, that was, and occasionally I would do, that would be a morning paper round. Sundays, the old, I always remember Sundays was, or Saturday, especially if someone had the times, it used to be like a fit, you know, because all the main papers were really big. Even the Daily Mail, the Daily Express, they were like the Telegraph still is and the Observer. They're all, other than the Mail and the Sun, but they're all those big news sheets, as I used to call them. And my bag, we used to weigh a ton. And occasionally I would do the evenings, because in them days you had the Evening News and the Evening Standard. So occasionally I would go back at 5:30, 6:00 and deliver. So yes, and that was basically my pocket money, as I was still at school. And well, obviously when I left school, I got a job. A lot of the vinyl was, which really, I spent my money on either football buying records, which say I've still got. And I always remember the first time I saw Queen, as I said earlier on, in November 1974, loved them. Killer Queen was at number two at the time. And I went out on the Saturday to buy their first three LPs, Queen 2, which I showed you, and Sheer Heart Attack. That's how I got into it. And I will, you always, because I've got a few bits of vinyl here, and here's the original, 1975, Bohemian Rhapsody, and that was in the old picture, yeah. And also, I'll quickly show this one, but at the moment, what can I say? Enough said about that. But it was like, and you love this one, yes, I did buy it, Adam and the Ant, Stand and Deliver. But when you open it, this is the single. It opens up, look, great big poster of him. you can see it. There he is, Adaman. And that is how things, used to get them. And this, and the record, there it is inside. So, I don't know if these are worth much, but there you go. And it's also, this one is by ABC. And it's actually comes in, their own. And you open it, and the music, the records, there's two records inside in their own ABC. So it's incredible, which is lovely. How you collection nowadays, obviously, you download your music, you don't get any of that. And then, of course, as I said, only a selection here, they change to CDs. It's Mike and the Mechanics, another band I've seen with Jane about 3 or 4 times. Mike Rutherford, he's in Genesis. And also, who else? The Cause, Best Of, and of course, Magic, we know. And of course, a few classical. So I'm just going to play a couple more. God, how time flies. Unbelievable. I think this is AC/DC, but that's something I've got on my phone. A couple of sort of classical ones that bear to mind that I liked. And I'm trying to, here we go. Which is, changes the tempo. Because like a lot of us, we're into different types of music. I like me rock music, the old head banging. Disco, Cool and the Gang, The Whispers, all them type of bands. Something dancey, like Mud and all that, but also classical. This is Vivaldi, The Four Seasons, but this is Spring. Oh, Great Inheritance for Rebecca and Matthew, Marsden's In the Cross. Well done, Lynn. Yes, the shop was called Marsden's. And of course, in the town, there used to be the old classic shop HMV, which is where McDonald's is now, for those who are not aware. And I used to love going uptown to, let's just turn this down a bit. There used to be the big, because HMV, his master's voice with the dog, with the gramophone, was in Oxford Street. And it used to be a lower floor, ground floor, upper floor. If Jane was shopping, I'd say, I'm just nipping into HMV, I'll see you in about an hour. Because then they started selling CD, and then you got the videos, didn't you? And then obviously DVDs, etc. But unfortunately, a lot of them places are obviously closing now. But used to love going around them shops. And I don't know what else I've got. Hold on, bear with me. Come on, Dave, sort yourself out. Oh, I like this one. I'll turn this one off. This is back in the 60s. This always gets you up dancing. Daydream Believer. You know this one? There's still an HMV at the RV Centre in Arlo. Oh, I'll have to go there. Another one I like this one very quickly. Anyone know it? It's one of those records you have loud in your car. Just you driving, of course, no one else. Bit of U2. Can't fault it. But this is another one. I know a lot of people like this. Another one from the 80s. I suppose the 80s was my period, because by then I'd be sort of in my 20s. Used to, even I like, you know, Spandau Ballet, Duran Duran. I couldn't get it all out tonight. A few of their singles and albums and groups like that. Toto, and there's below that is Sultans of Swing. Do you remember them? Let's hold on. Let's sort that out. But just to finish off, we will have our prayer as we normally do. That's just a rough selection of my music. But yeah, I like all types of music. As I say, my two brothers, I've got two brothers, completely different. Martin, next one, he was into Motown. Diana Ross, his hero, Stevie Wonder, all the Motown sound, the Four Tops, the Temptations. Then my elder brother, Richard, he was into The Who, Emerson, Lake and Palmer, Led Zeppelin. So completely different, but we all had our mixture, and we all love each other's, but you obviously distinguish where mine is sort of Queen, etc. Everyone to their own, which is what it should all be about. But I will play one song before we go, because I must wish today is Violet's birthday. And I must wish her, Violet is, as many of you know, is the church's finance officer, and she is 60 today. So give me 2 seconds. I'm sure we can sing her happy birthday. And I did save it. And so happy birthday to Violet. I did say she's 60, so you shouldn't say a lady's age, but I'm sure she won't mind. Enough, too late now, isn't it? So, yes. We will... It's not an instrumental version, is it? Let's get on a bit. Happy birthday, Brian.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. I just never understood how men who died for good could not have a David Wood.
So, yes, good evening, Violet, if you're watching this now or later, happy birthday to you. So thanks, yeah, happy birthday. Janice is thanking you, Carol, everyone else. Very nice. So, yeah, Stevie Wonder from Potter and July. Jane's got the album, yeah. Right, just to finish off, and then we'll have our last song. If you can bow your heads for prayer, please. Yes, be present, O merciful God, and protect us through the silent hours of this night, so that we who are wearied by the changes and chances of this fleeting world may rest upon your eternal changelessness, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And in peace we will lie down and sleep, for you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety. And the Lord bless us and watch over us, and the Lord make his face to shine upon us and be gracious to us. And the Lord look kindly upon us and give us peace. Amen. So can we now join in to say the traditional Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Amen. Thank you. So, yes, thanks for joining tonight. And hope you all have a good weekend. And hopefully I will see some of you on Sunday online on Mass. I know you're always on there, which is fantastic. Hopefully it's not too wet this weekend. I don't know if it's going to happen. Bit of snow come Sunday. I don't know if it will come this far. They said more Eastern England and up a bit, but you never know. A couple of weeks, Sundays ago, we did have that little bit, didn't we? Didn't last long. Yes, as I say, don't forget, if you wish to return your palm crosses, you can. The bucket is placed in the porch by the vestry. So anytime you're passing, and if you would like to return your crosses for burning the ashes for Ash Wednesday, it would be much appreciated. So before I go, I've got to play my last song. And I suppose, as I have said, my favourite group is Queen. And as I say, between, 74 and 86, I saw them about 12 times. Different venues, Rainbow, even the Tottenham Mayfair, Hyde Park Live, Nebworth, Wembley, Earls Court, etc., etc. And you can probably guess what it is. We're not going to play it all. But just to finish the evening off, 6.5 minutes of pure magic. 3 songs in one. And I always remember, this is November 75. And obviously it was over Christmas into 76. And I always remember when I first heard this, I thought, what is this? That will never do anything. No one will play it. Get to number one. And of course it did. Kenny Everett helped. And as we say, the rest is history. Even, 40, 50 years on, I will pass it on to the... Head banging when this bit happened, when I used to have my long hair back in the 70s. Oh yeah, there you go. So yes, thanks for joining us, and just a snippet of my record collection. I'm sure a lot of you have got your music that you love, which is fantastic. I keep it safe, and as I say, I've got a newer record player, so I do occasionally get it out when I can. Which is nice, the old scratchy vinyl. Nothing sound like it. So Waynesville, Father Vince, me and you gotta have a talk about our music. You're booked. So so thanks for joining us again, and I will see you shortly, probably if not before next Friday, but at Mass on Sunday if you're joining us. Have a good weekend, have a peaceful night. God bless, and see you soon. Thanks for joining. Good night.